Hello and welcome to a new episode of Eliphas Leary's Lectures About Magic. This time I want to talk about physical exercise in general. Physical exercise is a very important thing in magic. Sometimes people think they can just ignore that and proceed start with the other stuff, the exciting stuff. That's a mistake. Physical exercise, in my humble opinion, should aim for the dissolution of the imaginary division of body, mind and soul, which is a result of lacking consciousness for bodily functions. So, first of all, there are very different forms of physical exercise. In the club called Illuminates of Thanateros, in the old books, I know what they are doing today has not much to do with the old books by Pete Carroll, although those books are very good and, well, a must-have for serious practitioners. In those books by Pete Carroll, there is a division in inhibitory and excitatory, I think, are the words he uses, techniques. The best known example for a technique that inhibits the body from doing stuff is quite possibly Hatha Yoga, which means you sit there calm and try to not move as much as possible. That's very good exercise. Hatha Yoga is very good stuff. I did a video about that a while back. Now there are also other techniques, and I would say there are at least three different categories. Because the excitatory methods, the exciting methods of physical exercise, for example, martial arts, or different forms of dancing, are very good, but you should also add stuff where you just let your body do what it does best. And one example for that is dancing, wild dancing, real wild dancing. Go to a drum and bass party or some party where people really dance without paying attention for what the body does. Go to a punk rock concert and take part in the slam dancing. You can perceive or experience, while letting your body just do what it does best, that your body really knows what it does. Wonderful example for that is when you walk around. You do not, and this example, I don't know where I stole it from, but you do not really command your body to move every muscle in the exact correct way. Your body knows how to walk. You don't even think about walking. You're walking. Your body walks. And in the same way, the body has consciousness is a very important property of the body. The body is conscious, but the consciousness most of the time doesn't have to care for all those tiny little functions of the body. In one of the Star Trek movies, there's this wonderful dialogue between Data and a child, where Data asks, how do you cope with your legs getting longer every second, and then how do you manage not to fall on your face? Well, the body has a form of intelligence that is very helpful if you trust your body. So, physical exercise can help a lot. All kinds of physical exercise can help a lot with not only learning how to trust your body, but also becoming consciousness, becoming conscious of all those things your body does on its own. And trusting your body is trusting yourself. So, quite important, not only for magic. What else was there? When we take a look at the symbolism in the Judeo-Christian tradition, we find something very interesting. We find those four animals that are connected to the four elements, and there's the bull, the lion, the eagle. The eagle. I think I said some bullshit in the German version. Well, you're the lucky guys. the lion, the bull, the eagle, and the human. And the human is ascribed to air. And air is the element of language, of symbols, of symbol systems, of logic, and all that stuff. By that, we find in this tradition that humans are at home in their world of thoughts, in their imagination, in their languages. And most of the time, people will not be able to, to do something as long as they can't put it in words. They have to put it in words to really understand it, or at least to put it in a symbolic system, for example, mathematics. That's most of the we mistake our thoughts for our consciousness. And physical exercise can help you get around that mistake, to expand your consciousness on other levels. Now there is a guy I have to talk about, and I don't like that guy. His name was Wilhelm Reich, and he was a scientist up to some point. And from the point on where he was possessed by the orgone, he ceased to be a scientist, because he rejected all kinds of falsification and he just looked for verification. Now that's not how science works. All right, to his defense, I think the theories of Karl Popper were not around in those times, but he ignored everything that falsified his idea of the orgone. And when you're just after verification of what you believe, then, well, that's not science. You will not get anywhere useful. But there is one thing in Wilhelm Reich's work that I really like. That's this emotional body armor. And, emotional body armor, of course, is that emotions that you try to ignore, that you do not want to face, you banish them, so to speak, and they find a place to live in your muscles somewhere. And there are many figures of speech that express this this interaction of body and emotion, like the butterflies in your belly, or something sitting in your throat, or something like that. As English-speaking people, you know more of these figures of speech than I do, so come up with them and put them down in the comment section, or where YouTube put the comment section. So this emotional body armor is a very interesting concept, and it should important point in physical exercise is to dissolve that emotional body armor, as well as the imaginary division of body, mind, and soul. The body is consciousness. The body is where the senses are. The senses are a function of the body. And consciousness is not something somewhere beyond or hovering above the body. Of course, we shouldn't forget that our imagination is the best simulator in the whole universe. Important point. Now, what did I want to say? Something about... Oh, yeah. People ignoring their emotions, forcing those emotions into the body armor, and making that body armor stronger, which is what we all do. Even with years of Hatha Yoga, you still do it. That's why you keep on doing Hatha Yoga, or whatever kind of physical exercise you're doing. And by that, the body becomes a kind of trash heap for all the emotions we do not like to process. We do not like to face. We do not like to have. And that's not a good thing. A conscious life should be a life where you accept all the bad stuff and don't try to run away from that. So being hostile towards your body, which is quite often expressed and in people believing that there is spirit and there is matter. No, there isn't. There is only matter. Spirit doesn't matter. Sorry. Well, people who believe that there is... that there are two worlds, well, I never met someone who could really give evidence for another dimension, a spiritual dimension, or anything like that. And as long as there is no evidence for it, why should you take it serious? Why should it matter if you can't provide evidence for a spirit or mind or whatever dimension? There is no such thing. So, well, I hope you got something out of this. And if there is something that you want to complain about, or if there are any ideas you would want to put in my mind, use the comment section or send me a PM or whatever. Don't send me a raven. Well, as always, enjoy yourself, enjoy your time, enjoy everything, and see you soon.